अज्ञानतिमिरान्धस्य ज्ञानं जनशलाकय चक्षुरुन्मीलयन् तस्मै श्रीगुरवे वंशाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो महावदन्नाय कृष्णप्रेमप्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्णचैतन्य नाम्ने गौरवशिषे गुरवे गौरचन्द्राय राधिकायै तदालये कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तद्भक्ताय भक्त्याभिहीनाय पराधलक्ष्यै चित्तस्य कामादितरङ्गमध्ये कृपामयीं त्वं शरणं प्रपन्ना वन्दे नमस्ते चरणारविन्दं यं प्रव्रजन्तमनुपेतमपेतकृत्यं द्वैपायनो विरहकाचर्याद् पुत्रेति तन्मयतया तर्वोभिनेदु तं सर्वभूतहृदयं मुनिमानतोऽस्मि त्वयैवास्मि त्वयैवास्मि न जीवामि त्वया विना इति विज्ञायराधि तन्मय माम् Yesterday I explained so much Guru Tattva from Chaitanya Chaitamrita that who should be Guru? We should try to accept a bona fide Guru. These symptoms have been given in Srimad Bhagavatam. And then your desire will be fulfilled. If you want to buy some gold, and if you are going to a fruit seller or vegetables shop, can you have gold? Never. You may cheat. Oh, I'm giving gold, but he will give you some vegetable or not really gold. So you should go where? Bona fide shopkeeper, and he may. So you should go to a guru that I, not myself, but Shastra has told. Krishna is himself told in Vedas, Upanishad, Bhagavatam. Why you should go to any bona fide guru? I have also explained. To fulfill our object. So we must know our object. Maharaj, can you tell the object of your sadhan bhajan and your life? What is your object of your life and why you accepted a guru? What was your purpose?
Our object in life of accepting the lotus feet of a pure devotee is to obtain love of Radha and Krishna. And
help me.
Krishna Prema.
something he has told one, but something more. Why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came to this world? To attend that fellow. Anarpacharim chira karne avatirna kalo samarpayitam unnatat jalrasam sabhakti si harihapurat sundar dhyut kadamba sandhita sadaritaya kandare skurutamesha. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu kindly manifested his all desires. Why he came to this world? Swarup Goswami is clearly giving explanation. What is that? Samarpayitum unnato jalrasam sabhakti isyam. He only came who? Krishna himself is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So taking the beauty and intrinsic mode of Radhika, mercifully he came to this world. Oh, there were two motives. Samare payitum unnato jalrasam sabhakti isyam. First we should know that Krishna is so merciful. There are none merciful like Krishna and Parlok. And other hand, he is very rasic. So, as he is rasic, he wants to test the moods of Radhika. And secondly, he is so merciful, he wants to give some part of what he was testing, he has come to taste. And that thing is unnata ujjal arasa samarpayitum. He has come to give very high class of love and affection. That is called unnata ujjala rasa. What is unnata ujjala rasa? What he tasted in Vrindavan Raja? All kinds of rasa is tasted, but Braja rasa, the love and affection of gopis, how they used to serve Krishna, oh, this was most high thing. And among all the rasas, oh, topmost is Radha love and affection to Krishna. That love cannot be given to anyone. Only Krishna can follow something. So he came to follow. And to sprinkle unnata ujjala bhakti rasasri, this parkiya bhav, parkiya mood of gopis, even it is not found in Dwarka, in any of the things, only some shadow is there, not fully is there. And what to tell in Lakshmi, Sita or anyone? A special thing. The beauty of Radhika mood. Swabhakti means here, swa means Krishna himself. Om. Who is on of Krishna? Radhika. Her love to Krishna is highest topic. And its beauty is It's a beauty. What is beauty? Gopis are the beauty of Radhika. Among them, Lalita, Vishakha, Chitra, these, or Chandravali, or all, they are all Naika of Krishna. Not beauty, but expansion. They are expansion of Radhika. But, her beauty is Rupmanjari, Rati Manjari. Here Mahaprabhu came to shower his mercy, to give, to distribute the modes of Manjaris. How to serve Radha Krishna? Conjugal, but some part inclination towards Radhika. Radhika is my Swami. This mode. I will serve Radhika, and in her guidance, I will serve Krishna. If Krishna will call me to engage in her service, I will totally refuse. Totally refuse. But Srimati Radhika, if wishes, I can follow, otherwise not. Having no gain,
selfishness,
anything, only to serve totally Srimati Radhika. So I will be happy if Radhika is happy. If Radhika is not happy, I am not happy. This way. If Krishna is defeated, oh, very happy, very happy. And if Srimati Radhika is defeated, then, oh, so much. Unhappy. In this way. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came to sprinkle this mercy that our highest goal is to serve Radhika. And that is told by Rupa Goswami, Raghunath Goswami, Kaviraj Goswami, and all up to last acharya, all has. This should be our goal. To serve Radhika, he should be our master. He should be our everything. Tavai vasmi, na jivami trayavina. Iti vijnaya radhi, tamne maam chayam. O Radhike, I am yours. You should be merciful to me. Accept me in your services. Please enlist my name
in your register.
In the register of your men servants. Or in the last, my name will be there. Right. So this is the aim and object, very clearly Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has told. And then process, we should begin from where? Adav Shaddha, Tata Sadhu Sambha, Tato Anartha Pindiki. Here I see so many devotees coming to me. Oh, today I have not chanted Hare Krishna Vishnu. Oh, I have not chanted, remembered our Guru Mantra. Oh, it depends on you, how you are following the instructions of Rupa Goswami. And if you are not doing, then we or any Guru or Rupa Goswami himself or Mahaprabhu is not responsible for that. So, in Srimad Bhagavatam, this upakhyan of Narad Goswami has been given in first In the beginning was Srimad Bhagavatam. And in the beginning of any literature, Vedic literature, you will see the glories of Gurudev. Narada was a boy of 5 years. And he was with her mother. One day, some high class of devotees like Chatuvasan, Sanak Sanandan, Sanatan, Sanandan, first son of Brahma, and how son? Not by any om, but his mind. He thought that I should have a son and 4 sons. By this way. Oh, very, very intelligent. Pure. Nothing worldly desires in them. And Brahma asked them, oh, you should be married and make some children. They refused and they went to forest to meditate Supreme Lord. Anyhow, by the grace of Brahma, again, they came in the line. And first he was, they were Nirgun Brahma Upasa. Oh, they were worshipper of formless Godhead. But by the grace of Brahma, they became the worshipper of Vaikunthanath. So they were high class of devotee. So, this 5 aged boy, Narada, a son of beggar, low class of any mother. Father was dead. She used to serve in any house and thus anyhow maintaining herself and his boy. So these 4 high class of like sannyasi renounce order, this Sanat Kumar and so many others devotees, they assembled there in the time of Chaturmasya, that very, very village of Narada Rishi. They made some huts. Anyhow, they were maintaining their life, but always 4 months as a regulation that we have done here. Always Harikatha, always Harikatha was there. So boy began to attend these classes and to serve all the rishis. How? By bringing water for them. Also helping them in their baths. When they used to go to Ganges or Jamuna, anywhere, he used to take his dry garments. And what garments? Not like us. No heavy. Only their door and coping, nothing else. Nothing. Door coping, you know?
Lion
club. So, only that. Their kamandalu for water.
Water
pots. And then serving, if any needs. And he has a taste, greed, to take the remnants of these Mahapurush. So, he just told him, Prabhu, please allow me to take your remnants. What is left in leaf plate. And they used to give something remnant for that boy. And thus in few days, the boy is totally changed, like a miracle. That is why in Chaitanya Charitamrita has been told, what has been told? That if you want to serve Krishna, you want the love and affection like Brajavasis, gopis, you should take first the remnants of sadhu, of sadhu, very high class of sadhu, devotee, real devotee. And these are two remnants. First remnant of Mahaprasadam and second Harikatha. Both. Mostly this Harikatha is remnant, is more powerful. So we should try to take it. Bhakta Padadhuli and the dust of that high class of sadhu. What is dust? What is dust? To be a dust of the holy feet. If sadhu is not giving any here, we see that we are quelled. And defeating that sadhu, we can take dust from his feet. This is not dust. This is not really dust of feet. To be a dust of that high class of devotee is really that dust. His mercy will come by then. And third is Bhakta Padajal. And the water washed of that devotee. Three things. And by the service of Krishna Prem, automatically, if he was sincere. If he was. So a change, miracle came in his life. That 5 years a year born. Always shutting. When 4 months expired, he was inspired so much. He began to wait. Now they will go to their destination. Sadhu don't live at a place like a river current. Like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu have seen, Rupa Sanatan, never at a place. So, when sadhus began to go to their destination here and there, because for 4 months of Chaturmasa, that is Varsha, rainy season, when? And they began to go, this boy began to cry and weep. I cannot be saved. I must die without you. I want to go with you. But there was a obstacle that his mother, always keeping in his lap, he never used to give up. But this force and became very, very pathetic to that child and gave a mantra. What is mantra? This mantra is nothing but himself God. Oh, Brahma Gayatri. Who is he? Oshmati Radhika Harsha. Omkar. Omkar is something which is clean. And what are they? Himself, Krishna with Radhika, with all the devotees, with some relation. So you should think that, oh, Gurudev has given this mantra, he has given me Krishna of Vrindavan, the beloved of all the devotees. Yes, and you should be satisfied by that. Always remembering and chanting. Like what? Oh, now comes. After giving the mantra, Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. And then they went. Boy was always crying and weeping and wanted that I should be out of my mother's lap. But now she was very careful. What? He should not go anywhere. So always keeping. And he was weeping, or Krishna heard he is weeping. And at once he came like a shark, very poisonous
snake.
Oh, what? Cobra. And bite her mother. She was dead. And he became very happy. Mother was lying down there. And he ran away to forest. What became of our mother? You know what became? If anyone is a father or mother of any high class of devotee, then he must
deliver from this world.
From this world. Oh, Krishna mercy to come. So mother must be a devotee in her
next life.
And we will come in process of bhakti, surely Krishna will help. So she was not tired, but she
changed her body.
And he had a body, she has a body like devotees, and she received guru, very high class of, or very soon, or she will attend praying. And in this end, this little boy went in a forest, running. Oh, very fast jungle. Only wild beasts, like lion and tigers and bears are there. And then he took bath in a very river or any pond. No fear at all. No fear. He has faith on the words of his guru. If you are surrender soul, any opposition cannot do anything to you. Krishna must save. And he was there. And began to chant that mantra. How unbroken as bhakti, in bhakti it has been told. And how he chanted, not like us, Om Namo Te Bhagavate Vasudevaya, not like this, unbroken, with whole energy, not mind here and there, one pointed, whole day and night, not only one year, continue. And thus some reflection of Krishna came and he saw for a moment and disappeared. And then he began to cry and weep loudly. We should try to follow this Narada of 5 years. Not like that. Sometimes partly he was serving anywhere in college and he was doing something here and there. And for 1 hour in morning he used to serve and mind was here and there and chanting Hare Krishna. Oh, how are you? Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Or chastising anyone who was making some
noise
to children. Gay Tesla. They can angry. Why you are shouting so much? And sometimes what to do in office. Oh, there is something. And Hare Krishna. This will not do. And we are all doing like this. We are very worried for maintenance. Now was he like this? Was very for maintenance or anything? He never took any balance of money. Bank balance or anything with him. No pocket. No shirt. What to tell pocket? And he wants on to remember him all the way. So this is the process. I think that you have come with your bank balances. And you are eager to see that when this will end and we will at once go and again we can join our jobs. Oh, this is not process. So try to follow this boy, Narada Rishi. His all senses were working for Krishna, for the benefit of Krishna. How I can serve? Oh, this Vasudev. And at last Vasudev came. That's all. So you should try to follow him. After that, when that light of Vasudev went away and he was crying, then aerial voice came. Oh, I cannot give you darshan. In this body, anyone in this world body, they cannot see me or realize me. Ata Krishna Amadi na bhavet grahya mindriyaiha shayan mukhaili jihvado swayam eva sphurat tada. You should know this very deeply meaning. Strongly you should know that what we are chanting from our mouth and tongue, this name is not transcendental. This is not transcendental. If you are following Rupa Goswami, Raghunath Das Goswami, our all Rupananda Vaishnava Acharya, then Krishna himself, Krishna name, his beauty, his sweetness, his everything will come and dance on our and then this name will be bona fide, perfect, pure name. Now we are crying. Having some this mode that I should receive that thing, attend that thing. But not fully we are. We have no fully faith on that. We have faith on our what we are doing, what we are earning. And then you will give up all these things, totally surrendered. Do it like Narada Rishi. Then transcendental name came. Up to now, no transcendental name was there. On the tongue of Narada, he was practicing by his own tongue, mind, heart and all. But when, after this, he left his body, he was going to leave his body. Oh, Krishna gave him. But he realized Krishna mercifully that who are you, your soul, his soul, and he gave up his that body, material body. And then transcendental body came and that automatically Krishna name always coming. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare,
Hare Rama, Hare Rama.
With what? Not only this coming name, but it was coming, like Rupa Goswami has written, तन्नाम रूप चरितादि सुकृतनानु क्रमेण रसना मनसी तिष्ठन् प्रजे तदानुरागी जनानुरागी कालं नयेत् अखिलां इत्युपदेशसार. How he wanted to take rest, but Krishna always riding on a horse like, always Krishna was there. And mind what doing? Remembering his all past times. If Rupa Goswami used to chant Damodar name, what was coming in his mind? Any worldly thing? What? Oh, Mother Yashoda, a churning.
Yogurt.
And what doing? Govinda
Namo.
Don't want to remember, but oh Krishna, like a chain, one after one, and that is called Swarasiki Upasana that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gave. Very hard thing. Not only mantra upasana, mai. Like one flower, not one pastimes of Krishna. When we meditate, then mantra upasana, like Damodar. But gradually coming, all these sweet pastimes of Krishna, like a garland, one by one, automatically coming. Then, all the Goswami like, chanting when any name and all that. Then Radha and Damodar comes. All the gopi, Titan, Krishna with Radhika. And then morning to again morning, all the lilas of pastimes of Krishna automatically will come. And this is called mantra. This is our goal. But how coming? So you must follow Narada Goswami as without any stop, uninterrupted, he was following this process. And if in hundreds of births, thousands of births, if you come to this stage, then that name and Krishna himself will come in our tongue, in mind, in heart. Then real this upasana will be begin, and then Krishna may come. Then will come what? Nishtha, ruchi, asakti, bhava, and all other things will gradually come. This is the process. You want to follow the process, but really not following. Oh, once in a day, I want this. One round and a stop. And that one round how? Oh, what will be if I am going to my job and they will kick out from my job because today I will be late, then what to do? And there are so many dilemmas. Love, pendulum of a watch. So this practice will not do. It will something. And that is why this stress is very critical. You have left something, your worldly thing, attachment, gradually you are giving them. But not having taste there, so at any time you can again accept worldly things. So we should not try to. We should be like, oh, Narad Goswami. And after that, what he did? This area of Palestine. He began to travel all over the world. And what doing? Always singing the glories of Krishna. Narada Bajaya Veena Radhika Rama. So always Radhika Rama he is doing. So after that he left his body and traveling in whole world and became personal associates of Krishna. Not only of Vasudeva, of Krishna. So you should try to follow this process. Not partly for Krishna you are doing. You are always engaged in this, that. So many kinds of job to maintain yourself. Being very weak. How it can be? Yono Vyas, his personal disciple, Vyas, Narada. He has engaged his whole, he was not a devotee. What? He was himself? Manifestation of Krishna. Narayan, Vyas. Satyavesh avatar. Empowered by Krishna. All kinds of tattva, Krishna, inspired in him. So Satyavesh avatar, like Vishnu, he was. He did so many things. He wrote all the Purans. He wrote Srimad Bhagavatam. Mahabharata. And in Mahabharata he left one jewel like
Bhagavad Gita.
Bhagavad Gita. Also there are so many jewels. So many jewels. Shanti Pad. Very high class of things. After that he compiled Vedas in four. And then he makes Brahma Sutra, the essence of all the Vedas. There were some unreconciled things in Veda. Somewhere it is written Krishna is not so said. And somewhere it is written that he has said. He reconciled all these things in that Brahma Sutra. So all the acharyas in India, they have explained the bhashya of that Brahma Sutra. He did it so, but not satisfied. Or that very Narada came. Who Narada? Now he has been the associate of Krishna. He came. And smiling. Oh Vyas, what are you doing? Are you happy? Oh, I am not happy. Why you are not happy? Oh, that I cannot say. I am patient. A patient cannot tell that what rogue is there. Only doctor, high class of vaidya, they can tell the rogue. Oh, I know your rogue. He had not to see the not to you should go and test your urine, your blood, your stool, or something from here taking. No need. He will see and he'll find that what is disease? Oh Guru knows. Expert Guru. But nowadays the Gurus, they don't know where is fault. Really they are not Guru. But they are imposing. that we are Guru. So Nal told that you have not explained anywhere in all Vedas that you have done, in Purans, in Mahabharata, that Krishna is Supreme Personality of Godhead. And He is ocean of rush. All the manifestations are coming from Krishna. All the soul coming from His power. He has three powers. What? Chit Shakti, Jiv Shakti, Maya Shakti. Also something about Ladini, Sampit, Sandini. So all worlds are manifestations. Or, they have come from these Shaktis. So you should know all these things. Or you should write first. Krishna is Supreme Personality of God. In India there are so many things. Some are telling that Durga is highest tattva. Ganesh is highest tattva. Hanuman is highest tattva. And so many. Very confusion. So you have done something like this. You should write anywhere that Krishna is Supreme Personality of Godhead. Everywhere it has been taken that Jeev wants to meet Him, but you should write Krishna wants to meet all the Jeevas. We are not worried so much, but Krishna is worried for us. You should write. Krishna is weeping for her mother. Mother is not, she can taste the ear of Krishna and she will bind Krishna. Though Krishna is Supreme Personality of Godhead. And what doing Krishna? Oh, mummy, 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 mummy. So we should know these things. Krishna is eager to meet gopis. And what he is doing? On a full moon, playing on flute. He is calling whom? Clang. And by this, he is calling, oh, Radhiki, Lalite, Vishakhe, Chitri. You should come. Otherwise, I will not be safe. He was calling. And at once, all the gopis, from here and there, that corner, from 10 corners, they ran to Krishna, to save Krishna. So Krishna was calling them, and how they can be in their houses. They were thinking, I am alone going. And all were running towards Krishna. And they went to Krishna. And what became? Krishna told, very good, you have come to me. Now you should return back to your home and serve your husband. They were thinking that Krishna is very naughty. So Krishna should tell, and in the last we will answer. Very interesting things. But now I am not going to. I want to make a greed in your. That very greed should come, and this is our object. Go, Brahma. Hari Hari Go! Tomorrow we will again.